Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. abolishes two government offices through his first executive order. Those are the Office of the Cabinet Secretary and the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission. Marcos cited the need for a just allocation of resources amid the ongoing health and fiscal crises for his move. The PACC's functions will now be transferred to the Office of the Deputy Executive Secretary for Legal Affairs. As for the Office of the Cabinet Secretary, its secretariat will be placed under the control of the Presidential Management Staff. While the EO dismantled two offices, it created the Office of the Presidential Advisor on Military and Police Affairs, which shall be under the administration of the Special Assistant to the President. President Marcos mandates the reorganization of the Presidential Communications Operations Office. It will now be called the Office of the Press Secretary. It will handle government-owned channels and other attached agencies. Also under EO No. 2, the Philippine Information Agency, or PIA, will now be placed under the direct supervision of the Office of the President. Offices that were handled by the PCOO will be merged into PIA. Those are the Freedom of Information Program Management Office, the Good Governance Office, and the Bureau of Communication Services. The EO cites the need to rationalize and consolidate the communications arm of the administration. Several senators back the first EO of President Marcos. Senator Coco Pimentel says eliminating the duplication of functions of government agencies is a good decision. He hopes such a move would lead to some savings for government. But he says Malacañang should be transparent and announce how much money is going to be saved through their reorganization efforts. For Senator Chis Escudero, less bureaucracy is always better, so more money can be allotted for projects that directly benefit the Filipino people. President Marcos meets with energy officials to discuss the agency's plans in addressing the global oil crisis. Photos of the meeting were posted on the president's official Twitter account. But no further details were mentioned. The Philippines is dealing with a high fuel prices due to tight supply at the world oil market following Russia's war in Ukraine. Marcos has yet to appoint his energy secretary. Former PACC Chairman Greco Belica surprised by the move of President Marcos to abolish the agency he used to head. Belica points out their work under the Duterte administration led to increased revenues for government. He says other anti-corruption agencies must now be strengthened with the PACC gone.
Kung palalakasin lamang po ang ombudsman, dadagdagan na mas maraming pondo, iaayos yung batas para mas maging aktibo sila, lalagyan sila ng law enforcement group. Kung palalakasin ng ombudsman, maganda na po yun. If they want to be in PCGG, maganda rin po yun. Dahil ang point ko lamang po is whatever it is na palalakasin natin para sa anti-corruption fight, eh, dapat po dagdagan ng pondo, palakihin ng jurisdiction, padamihin ng tao.
A political analyst meanwhile agrees with the decision of President Marcos to abolish the PACC. Tony Lavinia says the commission, like other agencies under the office of the president, is redundant.
It's actually a superfluous body because there are already existing institutions for anti-corruption. We have the ombudsman, we have the Civil Service Commission, and the president himself can create anybody every time that there is something to be investigated within his ranks. I cannot even recall of any major decisions that that commission has made that made a difference in terms of corruption, to be quite honest.
Lavinia also laid down his expectations after Marcos decided to place the Freedom of Information Program under the Office of the President.
I certainly expect them to follow the spirit of the regulation that they will order everyone to comply with the basic tenets of freedom of information, which is that the citizen request, we kind of need that in our system because of all sorts of things that are happening, right? That are not transparent. So I hope that the Office of the President has the clout to be able to tell departments and also to be able to apply that to itself. Then a problema, because many of the secrets are also by the Office of the President. Anything that's done, you know, in a public way in Malacañang needs to be shared to the public.
Unemployment in the Philippines climbed in May. The joblessness rate rose to 6% for the month, which translates to 2.93 million unemployed Filipinos. That's up from April's 5.7%, where 2.76 million Filipinos were jobless. The agriculture and forestry, as well as the public administration and defense sectors, suffered the largest drop in employment. The underemployment rate also went up by 0.5% compared to April. Underemployed persons are those who seek additional hours of work or want to have an additional job.